In this video, I have to fix this transmission. Might not be what you think though. It's all together and I have to fix it. Oh, I gotta make this back on. Welcome back to Prairie Wings Performance. I'm Merle Mayer. Anyway, what we're talking about here is this broken chunk out of the tranny. So a shop in town had an issue with an exhaust, and the exhaust was all bent, the bracket was bent, and they tried to just give it a little tug, and unfortunately it's bolted to this, and this thing now is not on the truck. They do not want to disassemble this. They've already talked to the customer. They're willing to go with it. I said I would give it a try. I'm a little freaked out though, because flammable liquid in a confined space. I'm gonna be back purging it through the vent. Hopefully that works. And then I'm just gonna give it a go and hopefully it goes good. I'm not gonna have the whole process for you. I'm gonna clean this all up, put it on, and we'll just see if we can do a repair on this with this together. They've taken the valve body out, but the rest of it's together. So hopefully, I don't know. There's a chance I'm gonna cook some seals and stuff in there, but we'll do our best not to. If you don't make a plan, you plan to fail. I cleaned that up reasonably well. I tapped it and actually is sticking in there. Now, of course, they're really gonna have to clean the inside of this transmission before they put it together. But my plan is, on this Allison transmission, it has a vent tube right here and one down lower. And what it did is wide together right here up to the top one. So I have a back purge going right now. So it's been going for about 5 minutes. Not sure if you can hear, but I got flow coming out of there of argon. So the idea is everything on this is sealed up, and I am hoping to evacuate all of the air, oxygen, everything out of this transmission. So in case we do have some kind of flare up, it doesn't, well, I'm hoping that there's no flare up because of what we're doing. The plan is to do this as cold as possible, little stitches, so I don't heat up this case too much to burn out seals. And I'm just gonna go for it. So that's the plan. I have welded lots of crazy stuff before. Not really too worried about this, but you think I'm being dumb for what I got going on? I'm gonna increase my back purge a little while I'm welding. And I don't know, we'll give it a go here, see what happens. Yeah, if anyone else has done this, let me know. I've never done a tranny together with fluid sitting in it. That didn't want to weld at all. So much crap boiling out of it. That is some ugly. I guess I'm gonna be moving some stuff around here. Now, of course, they promised me that this is not getting bolted, any exhaust or anything bolted to it. And me welding that has moved this aluminum a whole bunch. I think once we get her going there, it's gonna weld out okay. It is boiling a lot of garbage out. I think she's gonna work okay. I'm gonna have to grind that off, grind all the ugly off, and I'll get you back set up. Did some quick little handy dandy grinding stuff where I got these three tacks started, and we're gonna just see what we can do here. Hey, short little weld. And this is not a strength weld. It's just something to stop a leak. There's no pressure inside of this. So that is the deal, is just stop the leak. They tried JB Weld, I believe, but they didn't feel confident with it. So they said, nah, we're calling. Calling to get her sewed up with a weld. There is junk boiling out. Ooh, not gonna be the prettiest weld I've ever done, that's for sure. Still cool. Not cool, but cold. Merle made a funny. I don't want to get my weld area wet. I don't need any moisture in there at all or anything, but I want to cool it down. So I got a wet rag. I'm just going to protect that. Just going to stick that rag in there for a little bit. The whole point of this is making sure we don't hurt internals in this transmission. It's an emergency. This week has been just full of one thing after another. This thing, I think they dropped it off Monday or Tuesday, and it is Friday. So the whole week's been emergency stuff after emergency stuff. Gonna go through lots of argon on this one.
I always tell my students when I was teaching in school welding, I say, never keep welding once you dipped. Well, with aluminum, yeah, I'm wrecking my tungsten and I'm actually causing
some nasty weld. Ooh, that got warmer. Yeah, it'll sizzle. Hopefully they'll forgive me. If this was a ferrous metal, you would definitely be stopping instantly if you dip. That's some ugly. There's poo boiling out of there. This top housing's still good. The bottom definitely feels hot. Now, normally, if I was doing a repair like this, all this crap that's boiling out of it, I would grind this off and re-weld it. I'd V it out, it'd be a full pen weld, but this will be a great repair for what they need. She's warmer. I'm gonna slow my back purge down and I'm gonna let this transmission cool down. Thermal conductivity of aluminum is insane. Transmission is cooled. Back purge is back up. Let's see if we can put some more ugly on this. This bottom area right here is just full of sludge. I think we're gonna need a cool down again here. That's all still nice and cold. I definitely wouldn't want to put my fingers down on the bottom there, but the top of the housing is not, none of the water's evaporating off there, so I think we're gonna keep going. That is some serious grossness. I guess we're gonna leave this sit and cool again. This is literally just, everything here is cold, so feeling pretty good. Feeling pretty good about it. I'm not even melting the plug out of the back here, so that is awesome. It appears that all of the bubbles and pockets and crap are filled up. We'll take a look. Back purge is off. Okay, this is some fancy dancy welding here. So this bottom area underneath here was just loaded with crap coming out. It was spitting in pockets, blowing up, probably junk in the casting. This is literally just a surface weld to seal it up. And guess what? Allison didn't blow up on me. She's done. And I'm sure the shop is going to be very happy. The owner of the truck is going to be very happy because, yeah, she can go back in. I did it. I'm not real proud of it, but if you want, leave some comments. I probably could have done a lot of things differently on this and better. This is a hurry, let's get it out of here kind of thing. I'm way behind on where it should be. I tried sneaking it in, but I didn't get it in as fast as I wanted. So if you don't mind, please like, share, subscribe, and comment. That'd be great to hear your comments.